My name is Miia Martinsuo, and together with Martina Huemann, we will have two editorials in the International Journal of Project Management dealing with case study research in project studies. Now we introduce the first editorial about designing the case study. Research on projects, programs, project organizing, and project business includes a lot of case studies. Case studies look at the phenomenon in its natural context, in a real-life setting, so that they are indeed very suitable to project studies. They typically deal with contemporary events where researchers are not directly manipulating the investigated behaviors. Researchers, however, may choose to take a passive or active role concerning the conditions in which the case takes place. A lot of mistakes are made already when choosing case study as the research design. This is why we would like to offer some tips for designing case studies.
The key idea with this editorial is to share with you some tips on designing case studies. And what is important is to understand that these decisions need to be done early on. When writing the paper, it is too late. So design decisions that we are going to cover in this short presentation is choosing the case study as research design as such, helping you to understand how you really define the case. So by that, it also will become more clear what is the case and what is the context, because the context is very, very important when doing case study research. We also will cover the research philosophy that is underpinning your research. This is a very often very neglected dimension in designing a case study. Very much in relation to the research philosophy is the case study design and the case study strategy, where you can find different types of cases. And finally, we will end up with novel contributions you can make with case studies.
Indeed, one of the key decisions in designing case study research deals with selecting the unit of analysis, namely the case or cases. In the domain of project studies, the cases could be, for example, projects, programs, project portfolios. They could be project teams or certain job profiles like project managers or owners. They could be activities or processes, or even the organizations or networks that host the projects. You as a researcher make the choice, and it's quite important for you to justify your choice of case or cases clearly. The unit of analysis is directly linked with three other major choices: the phenomenon that you investigate, the analysis level at which that phenomenon is investigated, and the context in which the case occurs. It's quite a different story to study a large project as the case and the front-end management practices in it than to study different front-end processes of large projects as cases in terms of managers' behaviors. In all parts of the triangle, there's specific previous knowledge that you as a researcher have to review to spot the research need and justify your choices in your case study.
What is often neglected is the philosophical underpinning, the research philosophy that actually is leading your study. And this needs to be made explicit in the front end. You need to make your assumption explicit. And here you see on the one hand, the one dimension, the ontology, which tells us whether reality exists and spans to a continuum that reality does not exist. So it's more continuum, it's a little bit simplified, this figure. And the other dimension is epistemology. It's the nature of knowledge. And here we have the extreme position of the knowledge is independent of the observer and the knowledge is dependent on the observer. So it's very much the position of the researcher in regard to the knowledge creation. What you can see here is that depending on the stance you take, there is more objectivity or more subjectivity. So a very objective position here would be a positivist position, where the researcher has the assumption that reality exists and they could create the knowledge independent as an observer. The other extreme is subjectivity, and subjectivity comprises stances like pragmatism or radical constructivism. And here, the notion is that reality, social reality as such, does not exist, but it's always created in cooperation, a co-creation process between the researcher and the actors in the study. And that has implications to UK study strategy.
Directly building on the philosophical foundations, researchers have options regarding the approach they take. The most typical case study approach in the lower left corner relies on assumptions of objectivity. There are various exploratory, descriptive, and explanatory case studies, depending on the research purpose and goal of the researcher. In such case studies, the researcher views the world as an external observer, investigates objectively some data of real experiences and documented knowledge, and attempts to not have an effect on the case or the phenomenon being observed. However, case studies can also be done in interpretive, constructive, or interventionist modes, as this picture suggests. The top left corner refers to research traditions that enable the researcher to view the studied cases from the inside, for example, in ethnographic and interpretive modes. Also, the right side of this figure, action research, design science, and other approaches to intervention do use cases. Then the researcher or external consultant in some ways supports some transformation in the case or its context, while the researcher also collects data and carries out research on the case. We see positive possibilities with these various approaches to case study. However, in all of these designs, there's a need to report with equally rigorous approaches the methodological choices and procedures, as in all scientific papers. Also with case studies, we seek novel contributions, and there are many types of novelty and many types of contributions that are appreciated. Researchers that aspire reporting case studies in project-related business should remember a few main issues concerning the contributions sought. First, there's no need to attempt to generalize from a case to a population. That's not pursued in case studies. Second, it's quite important to build on existing theory and connect the contributions with earlier research to spot the research need first, and then in the end to report the novelty in the findings. Third, case studies often contribute through new understanding, new frameworks, or even propositions. Such contributions are always assessed in light of prior knowledge, both concerning similar kinds of cases at the right level of analysis and the entire phenomenon in its context. Fourth, an important part of the validity of case studies deals with transparency to the data and traceability of the research process. These need to be documented well and reported in the method section of a research paper. Finally, the context has a crucial influence on cases and case studies. Therefore, audiences of International Journal of Project Management and other journals will appreciate insightful proposals for replication studies in other contexts and other future research. When concluding the findings of case studies, it's really important to discover strategic ideas for forthcoming research and guide also next researchers. Thank you for listening. We hope that you find our editorial as useful. This and other editorials will be found on International Journal of Project Management website.